The Ted Williams hip rotation style is where you hit against your front foot, which creates more power. It also gives you a slight uppercut, and the top hand is dominant. The best example of the weight transfer theory is Charlie Lau's prize pupil, George Brett. Lau talked about balance, rhythm, and relaxation. Note how Brett has the bat on the shoulder. This is going to produce a level swing and allow more contact because you can hit the ball out in front of you, even with you, or a little behind you. The weight shift is simply the forward shift of the body's center of gravity from back leg to front. Note also the head down and the release of the top hand off the bat. Barry Bonds employs a lot of the Ted Williams system. Note the bat is vertical, which will create an uppercut. He hits against the front leg, which pushes his hip structure in two opposing directions, generating a lot of torque and power out of the legs. He has a short swing and really gets the top hand through, although Bonds can go the other way with authority as well. Until now, those have been the two accepted theories. The future Hall of Famer Mike Schmidt, who studied hitting extensively, has a great new book out suggesting maybe a combination of both these styles could be just the ticket. Defending National League home run champ Fred McGriff hits against his front foot and rotates like Williams talks about, but he also keeps his head down and releases with a top hand, a la Charlie Lau. This ball went nearly 500 feet in the Astrodome. Schmidt thinks Will Clark combines the two theories about as well as anybody playing today. Clark can take the ball out over the plate the other way using the weight shift style, or if he sees the ball in, he can plant the front leg, rotate, and pull. However, this year, Clark has not been hitting the ball with quite as much authority. The home run total is really down, and it could be a myriad of reasons, but one source tells me his right elbow, his front elbow, has been bothering him.